There are several steps you need to do to accurately measure mass. First is use the right scale. We can use an equal arm balance, like this one, a digital balance, like this one, or a triple beam balance, like this one. When holding a triple beam balance, be sure to hold it by the base with two hands. Keep it secure. Never hold it by the beams. That's how it breaks. Let's look at the parts of the balance. You have the pan. That's where the object goes. Put the object in the center of the pan. You have beams. There are three beams. Each beam has a rider. The first one's in 100 grams, second one's in 10 grams, third one's in 1 gram. You have your pointer. That's how you know that it's in balance. And finally, you have the adjustment knob on the side. That's for zeroing out the scale. To weigh an object, you must first zero out the scale. Put all the riders on zero. However, this won't always balance out the scale. It needs to be zeroed out. So we use the fine adjustment knob on the side. Give it a few turns. Maybe go by a half a turn or a quarter of a turn until the pointer just balances. With the balance zeroed out, it's time to weigh our object.
Maybe I can be of assistance.
Let's find the mass of Professor Frink. Put him on the scale. But he has to be in the center of the pan. Next, move the largest rider one click at a time until the pointer drops below zero. That means you've gone too far. Move it back one click. Now try the tens rider. Move it out one click at a time, again until the pointer will drop below zero. Then move it back one click. Finally, slide the smallest rider out a little bit at a time until the pointer just balances. With the scale in balance, it's time to add up each rider. Be sure to have a team member check your work. Looks like 138.6 grams. What do you think? Yeah, 138.6 grams. Do you agree? Yes, 138.6 grams. When finding the mass of a liquid, you cannot just pour liquid on the pan. It'll spill everywhere. You have an extra step to do. With the scale zeroed out, find the mass of an empty beaker. Next, find the mass of the beaker and the water. With the scale in balance, the last step is to subtract the mass of the beaker from the mass of the liquid and the beaker. We can also find mass using a digital balance. Turn it on. If the scale is not in the correct unit, hit the unit or mode button until it's in the correct unit. This can be in grams, ounces, or pennyweight, abbreviation DWT. We want to use grams for mass. If the scale does not read zero to begin with, you can do two things. Remove the metal pan and clean it. Sometimes there's powder or liquid left over on there. Second thing you can do is hit the re-zero button, and that will just cancel it out. To find the mass of an object, place it in the center of the pan, and the scale will tell you the mass. To find the mass of a liquid, you can find the mass of an empty beaker, then find the mass of the beaker with the liquid in it, and subtract the two values. You can also put an empty beaker on the scale, hit the re-zero button, that'll cancel out that value, then when you pour in the liquid, you'll be taking the mass of just the liquid. No subtraction is needed using a digital scale. The computer does it for you. Finally, we can use an equal arm balance. This scale has a pointer in the middle. You're going to balance out both sides. You put the object on one side, in the center of the pan, and you place known masses on the other side. 500 grams is too much. The object weighs less than that. Try 200 grams. Again, that's too heavy. We put on 100 grams. Not enough, so we add more. 50 grams. So 150 is too much. Replace the 50 with a 20. 120 is not enough. Another 20. 140 is too much. Add a 10. 130 is not enough. So use a small rider and slide it out until it just balances. Then you add everything up. 138.6 grams. Follow these steps and you'll have accurate, reliable measurements for mass.